and welcome to BioTeach, where we answer your most unanswered questions. No more further introduction. Let's begin with our topic. Today's topic has been suggested by Mathilo Allegro. She said,
I know you are a man of honor. I'm so sorry to bother you at home, but I don't know where to go. And I came here all alone.
Whoops, wrong video. She actually said, can you guys make an animatic summary of replication, transcription, and translation? Well, you see, Mathilo, we can do the summary, but making an animatic takes months for it to finish. But we won't deny your request. So here is the summary of replication, transcription, and translation in a very hurried animatic. Enjoy!
DNA replication. Replication follows several steps that involve multiple proteins called replication enzymes and RNA. In eukaryotic cells, such as animal cells and plant cells, DNA replication occurs in the S phase of interphase. During the cell cycle, the process of DNA replication is vital for cell growth, repair, and reproduction of organisms. Initiation. Replication begins at the location on the double helix known as ORIC, to which certain initiator proteins bind and trigger unwinding. Enzymes known as helicases unwind the double helix by breaking the hydrogen bonds between complementary base pairs.
Elongation. With the primer as a starting point for the leading strand, a new DNA strand grows one base at a time. The existing strand is a template for new strand. The enzyme DNA polymerase controls elongation, which can occur only in the leading direction. The lagging strand unwinds in small sections that DNA polymerase replicates in the leading direction. The resulting small Okazaki fragments can contain 1,000 to 2,000 bases in bacteria.
Termination. After elongation is complete, two new double helices have replaced the original helix. During termination, the last primer sequence must be removed from the end of the lagging strand. This last portion of the lagging strand is the telomere section. Enzymes snip off a telomere at the end of each replication.
Transcription is the first step in gene expression. It involves copying a gene's DNA sequence to make an RNA molecule. Transcription is performed by enzymes called RNA polymerase, which link nucleotides to form an RNA strand using a DNA strand as a template. There are three steps in transcription. First is transcription initiation. To begin transcribing a gene, RNA polymerase binds to the DNA at the gene at a region called promoter. Basically, the promoter tells the polymerase where to sit down on the DNA and begin transcribing. Each gene has its own promoter. A promoter contains DNA sequences that let RNA polymerase or its helper proteins attach to the DNA. Once the transcription bubble has formed, the polymerase can start transcribing. Second step is transcription elongation. Once RNA polymerase is in position at the promoter, the next step of transcription, which is elongation, can begin. Basically, elongation is the stage when the RNA strand gets longer, thanks to the addition of new nucleotides. During elongation, RNA polymerase walks along one strand of DNA known as the template strand. For each nucleotide in the template, RNA polymerase adds a matching complementary RNA nucleotide to the end of the RNA strand. Last is transcription termination. RNA polymerase will keep transcribing until it gets signal to stop. The process of ending transcription is called termination, and it happens once the polymerase transcribes a sequence of DNA known as a terminator.
Translation, or specifically RNA translation, is the process by which a protein is synthesized from the information contained in a molecule of messenger RNA, or mRNA. Then, a transfer RNA, tRNA, molecule carrying the amino acid methionine binds to what is called the start codon of the mRNA sequence, the genetic code. During translation, a cell reads the information in a messenger RNA, mRNA, and uses it to build a protein. Actually, to be a little more technical, an mRNA doesn't always encode, provide instructions for a whole protein. Instead, what we can confidently say is that it always encodes a polypeptide or a chain of amino acids. In an mRNA, the instructions for building a polypeptide are RNA nucleotide. These are the A's, U's, C's, and G's. There are over 64 codons for amino acids, and each of them is read to specify a certain amino acid out of the 20 commonly found in protein. One codon, the AUG, specifies the amino acid methionine and also acts as a start codon to signal the start of protein construction. There are three more codons that do not specify amino acids. These stop codons, UAA, UAG, and UGA, tell the cell when a polypeptide is complete. Altogether, this collection of codon amino acid relationships is called the genetic code, because it lets cells decode an mRNA into a chain of amino acids. Getting started. Initiation. In initiation, the ribosome assembles around the mRNA to be read, and the first tRNA carrying the amino acid methionine, which matches the start codon AUG. Extending the chain, elongation. Elongation is the stage where the amino acid chain gets longer. In elongation, the mRNA is read one codon at a time, and the amino acid matching each codon is added to a growing protein. Finishing up, termination. Termination is the stage in which the finished polypeptide chain is released. It begins when a stop codon, UAG, UAA, or UGA, enters the ribosome, triggering a series of events that separate the chain from its tRNA and allow it to drift out of the ribosome.
And that's the summary of replication, transcription, and translation. Do we satisfy you with our answers? If not, check the links down below for more information about this topic. Once again, this has been BioTeach. Thank you for watching.